Howdy folks, welcome to InnerBark Outdoors. My name is Andy Tran, and in this video, I wanted to go over a new piece of reloading equipment that I got. It is the Breech Lock Hand Press by Lee Precision. If you've been following my channel for a while, you know that I do a lot of reloading, primarily with my Hornady Lock and Load Progressive Press. It's a great setup, but it takes up a lot of space. And now that I'm in a new location, I don't have that luxury of all that extra storage. So I did a little bit of research and came across this little device, and I've been pretty impressed with it so far. As you can see, this is all of it. It's a little bit larger than a standard full-size stapler, but it packs quite a bit of a punch. Check it out.
The press is made out of aluminum, which makes it lightweight. The shape of the components makes it relatively stiff as well. The piston is made out of stainless steel, and out of the box there was zero play in it. The breech lock that they added to this press makes it easy to swap out dies. The downside is that the bushings seem to be a little bit higher cost than what I'm wanting to pay. So instead, I used Hornady locking rings, which are cheaper, and they work great for my use. There's a spring-loaded clip that secures a shell holder, and it can be rotated in any direction. So let's go through some reloading with some 40 Smith & Wesson. We're going to size and deprime first. The primers collect inside of the hollow piston, which does make it a little bit dirty in there after a while. And you'll have to empty it every 40 to 50 rounds depending on the size primer you have. After sizing and depriming, we have to flare the mouths of the cases so that it'll easily accept the bullets. To prime, I'm going to be using a hand tool instead of the attachment that can be bought with this Lee press, which you can only do one at a time. So for this purpose, I'm using the RCBS hand press, which makes the job go by a lot faster. I have an assortment of powder dippers, and you'll need to check the weight with the charge. I'm using dryer sheets to make it so there's no static cling on this one. It's a cheap way to make sure that things aren't going to get stuck around and really mess with your powder weights. The same thing for the funnel. I want to make sure that the powder is not getting stuck to any component, so that I make sure that I have a consistent powder charge. Using a reloading tray, it's pretty quick and easy to start loading a bunch of charges. And with good light, you should go ahead and also check to make sure there's no double charges or squibs. Placing bullets on the case is a lot easier now that we've flared the mouths of the case. And because the bullets kind of stay there, it's a lot easier to reload because you're not putting your fingers in the way of the mechanism to make sure that everything's seated properly. And the last step is to seat and crimp. The seating and crimping is done in one step using the Lee seating die. What I like most about this setup is that everything that I need to reload fits into a single tackle box. So not only does it not take up very much room in my home, but I can easily take this into the field to develop my loads.
So that is the Lee Precision Breech Lock Hand Press. If you guys have any comments or questions, go ahead and message me directly or you can comment down below. If you guys enjoyed the video, please like, share, and subscribe. And also check out my Facebook page, Instagram, and other social media. It really helps you know these are the kind of videos you want to see. And stay tuned because I will be reloading some rifle ammunition very shortly. But as always, take care out there.